The demand for primary care physicians in the United States is growing faster than the supply.
Kenneth Craig shows us how a new medical school in Connecticut is working to fix the problem.
They're monitoring your heart rate.
Dr. Caitlin Norman just started her internal medicine residency at Waterbury Hospital in Connecticut, one of the final steps to achieving her lifelong dream of becoming a doctor.
The work you do has such consequences for people and their lives and their health.
And you see that every day here.
All the time.
The U.S. is in need of more primary care doctors like Dr. Norman. She's part of the first graduating class at Quinnipiac University's new medical school that is tackling the shortage in internal medicine, OBGYN, pediatrics, and psychiatry.
They focus on primary care.
The school's dean, Dr. Bruce Keppen, says primary care applicants are put at the top of the admissions list.
Primary care physician is your navigator through the healthcare system. They see you for every particular problem you have. They can refer you to specialists if that's the case, but they're the one who knows you the best.
It's estimated by 2025 there could be a shortage of up to 35,000 primary care physicians. Dr. Keppen believes money plays a role.
If you're graduating from medical school with several hundred thousand dollars in debt, you may choose subspecialty where your earning potential is greater.
Dr. Norman says she made the right choice about the kind of doctor she wants to be.
If you're able to control their pain, if you're able to explain their risk factors when they're afraid of, you know, inheriting something from family. It's equally beautiful and rewarding.
And she feels she's already making a difference.
Beautiful.
Kenneth Craig, CBS News, Waterbury, Connecticut.
Now, the inaugural medical school class at Quinnipiac had 58 graduates this year. Nearly 60% are pursuing primary care medicine.
All of these jobs pay well, right? These medical jobs.
Well,
but as the doctor in the story said, like, it's a money thing. The debt that these doctors graduate with, you can understand why they want to go on to more lucrative subspecialties, perhaps.
Yeah, you know? Certainly understand that. All right.